In this video, I ride Albion Hills single track trails. This was my first time visiting Albion Hills and I got to ride a part of their single track trails. I still have to return to ride a few on the northern part of the park. To not make the video too long, I will split it in three parts. You can find the timestamps below if you're looking for a specific trail. If you're new to Albion Hills, I would recommend you check their website to familiarize yourself with their color code system, as it will make it easier once you get there. The area is marked pretty well and they have maps spread around the park. I will put the link to their site in the description box. They have a few green rated loops, which are their green, yellow and blue trails, and they have a couple of blue rated loops, which are their black and red trails. They also have a series of single track trails rated anywhere from blue and black to one double black. Also be aware that there is a $7 fee per person to enter the park unless you have a membership. Whoops. On this day I also rode the Red Trail, which is an 8 km blue rated loop. I might upload it in a separate video, but would likely not be the full loop as it would be too long.
Okay. Wrong line.
This is a fun technical climb. I should have stayed to my left. The right side had loose dirt and I lost traction.
Nice.
This is the end of the trail. Now I'm heading to the last trail on this video, Summer Solstice. This trail has a couple of fun technical sections. In general, I found the Albion Hill trails to be fun and twisty with some good climbing challenges. And as always, I appreciate the lack of exposure that I see in the Don Valley all the time. That's it. Thanks for watching.